This presentation is about a review of the use of sugarcane pulp ash as an alternative material in concrete by TF Materials in Sweden and Tunisia. I'd just like to acknowledge those that assisted me in the project. And this project is aimed to discuss the applications based on of SCBA agro-based materials, refer compare materials, provide experiment, method analysis, results obtained, conclusions from the previous researchers. And it was, the purpose was to enable the student to apply the theory lens and to learn and understand the innovative in concrete technology. These are the outlines of the project or the presentations. And in the introduction, this is a raw waste materials obtained after the sugar has been removed from the sugarcane stalks, mainly found in tropical and subtropical countries. It's 100% biodegradable, and it can partially use to replace cement and final aggregate. These are some of the researchers that did conducted. And Sayad, Maggi, ETL, or etc. 2017 did the research. And then with 5% replacement, but he never concluded on the optimum amount. Whereas Kawade research on the same product, but he found the 15% maximum as it was his optimum. The methodologies, journals, and online were used, and it was based on how far the research proceeded in the study, advantages and disadvantages, and to infer the conclusion on the usefulness of the materials in construction. The findings, trial check was done between 0 and 30% partial replacement, and was then consisted of acquiring materials, designing or determining the physical and chemical compositions, designing the trough mix between 15 and 40, making cubes to check the strengths, compressive strengths, and determining the consistency, workability, and compressive strengths. The material used in the previous research practical was cement, sugarcane, pulpage, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, and 5% of magnesium sulfate and water. These are the results obtained by the previous researchers of chemical and physical properties. You got table 3 and 4, chemical and physical properties. And then based on those results shown previously, it was found out that the SCBA seems to have bigger values than ordinary Portland cement, which cause variation in workability and strength of freshly and hard concrete. The design of trial mix consisted of, or the test conducted was then the slam test, compressive test, and durability test by curing the 150 by 150 with ordinary and different percentage replacement. These are the results obtained. Shows in figure 3 or table 3A compressive strength resulting in normal water M35, and then compressive strength result in 5% magnesium sulfate solution in 35 MPa as well. This shows the workability slabs from between 230 millimeters to 280 of different mix. And the compressive strength of cubes of 7, 14, and 28 days in 30 MPa in normal water. This is also from different researchers, D. Hailu and Ding, shows the compressive strength in M20, 1 to 1.5 to 3 proportions, and then table F shows the reduction in compressive strength and the 5% magnesium sulfate at 28 days. The disadvantage was it increased the compressive and tensile strength according to DIO. It partially replaced the fine aggregates and cement in concrete, reduced cost, impact on high early strength and reduced permeability, its economic benefit. Another disadvantage is it leads to environmental pollution, and more replacements could cause gradual drops in compressive strength. What are the advantages, continues and disadvantages? Advantages is reduced construction cost, and performance is better than ordinary concrete to 10 to 15% replacement caused by higher silica in SCBA. It increasing the resistivity towards surface attack. And continuing its advantages, it says compressive strength was decreased when cured in 5% solution of magnesium sulfate compared to when it was cured in normal water. It's highly recommended to do more researches and do more practicals on it just to see, since it was never done in South Africa according to what I've researched. So I recommend the South African industries or cement industries to do more researches on it. In the conclusion, this is, like I said previously, it's a rare crop growing in over 110 tropical and subtropical countries, with a total produced in 2010, but more was producing millions of tonnage in 2018. Brazil and India are the world's most or major sugarcane production countries, with Brazil having over than 790 million tons in 2010 and 746 million tons in 2019 crop year. And just the last one here, unlike control mix, the 0% replacement, so SCBA mix have higher slump value, acceptable workability and consistency up to 15%, which is optimum replacement or partial replacement of both cements and fine aggregates. This might be due to the increase in surface area and sugarcane ashes. So adding SCBA needs less water for wetting than cement particles. This was the end of the presentation. Thanks.